Hello guys, I am Manjot from Lenspassions Photography. In my last video, you watched the new feature object selection introduced in the Photoshop 2020. You also watched the improved version of a subject selection. In this video, you will learn about new improved version of a lens blur feature in Photoshop 2020. Before going further, kindly subscribe my channel though didn't and click on the bell so you will be notified when I will upload a new video. So we start from where we left in last video, and that is the new improved subject selection. I recommend you watch the entire tutorial first, and once you understand it, watch it again and try it for yourself. As you know, the select subject commands lets you select the most prominent subject in an image in a single click, powered by advanced machine learning technology. Select subject is a trained to identify or verify of the objects in an image, people, animal, vehicle, toys and more. How you can assess select subject? For better understanding, I have already added the new background of bricks here. Select quick selection tool from the tools bar, choose select subject, or use object selection tool, click select subject in the option bar. Select subject automatically selects the prominent subjects in the image. You can see the select subject is more faster and focused at analyzing imagery, because it has been updated using Adobe Sensei AI machine learning and has improved edge detection. You can then refine the selection using other selection tools as I am showing in the image. If you want to know more about refining, watch my previous video. I have inserted the card above and added the link in the comment section. When we change the background, we need to add the color cast of the background to the subject. So I added a solid background and filled it with the new background with matching color. Bring the solid color layer above the masking layer. Choose the blend mode normal to soft light. See the difference before and after. Now following the same way, you can change any background. Now I come the very important feature that is also improved in Photoshop new version. Kindly watch video at the end because it will be very beneficial, and especially for those who can't afford fast lenses. With improvements made to the lens blur, you can take more advantage of the depth information in the image captured by your camera. You can now set a focal point to choose what to blur and keep in focus in your image. With GPU improvements, you will also notice faster performance while applying the lens blur filters, and blur to an image to give the effect of a narrow depth of field so that some objects in the image stay in the focus and other areas are blurred. You can use a simple selection to determine which areas are blurred, or you can provide a separate alpha channel depth map to describe exactly how you want to blur edit. When it comes to the creating depth of field in Photoshop, many users use Gaussian blur or other techniques that hardly look realistic or even close to the depth of field a real camera creates. In this video, you will watch how to create realistic depth of field in Photoshop using depth maps. First, I am using Gaussian blur feature. I have already made the selection by using subject selection and refining the same. Now going to the filter menu and select the Gaussian blur. Enter the desired value and click OK. Effect is not showing because it is a masking layer, so I am disabling the mask. Now background is blurred. You can see here ghost appearance is showing on the edges of the subject. I am zooming it and it is very much clear. So that lens blur is more important. Now I am again start from the mask layer after undo the all actions. Go again the filter menu and this time select lens blur. Going to the depth map menu and select the layer mask. And background was blurred perfectly. You can also adjust the depth by using slider. You can also invert the blurring effect either foreground or background. You can also specify the depth by using new crosshair cursor. Click that area where you want to shadow or deep depth of the field. After adjustment, click OK. Effect was already applied, so I am disabling the mask, and now you can see the realistic blurred background. No ghost appearance and not any fringe is showing. Why the difference before and after? In this image, we simply need to blur the background. But what you can do, where so many objects or require selective blur that we can't blur like as a single background. It does not make sense. So in that case, we need to create a depth map. The lens blur filter uses the depth map to determine the position of pixels in an image with the depth map selected. You can also use the crosshair cursor to set the starting point of a given blur. You can use alpha channels and layer masks to create a depth map. Black areas in alpha channels are created as though they are at the front of the photo, and white areas are treated as if they are the far in the distance. So first need to create an alpha channel. I already opened an image here. You can see multiple objects near or far the subjects. Select the main subject with subject select and refining it. Choose selection and click OK. Use Ctrl plus J in Windows and Command plus J in Mac to create a new layer of a selected pixels. Now time to create a depth map. You need to decide which selection you want to focus or blur. The darker the shade of the gray, the less blur is applied to your image. And black is a fully focused and white is a fully blurred. And the gradient on the right is the gradient used on the channels as an alpha layer. So you need to fill black the selection by using Alt plus Backspace in Windows and Option plus Backspace in Mac to keep woman in fully focused. Take care, foreground should be black in tool panel. After that I am selecting the foreground in dark gray, want to slightly blurred. First make selection, then fill it with dark gray. Now I am selecting the rocks little behind the subject. These are not so far behind. So after creating selection, I filled it medium gray. Means these are will be blurred less than dark gray. Now I want to blur the all background. So after making selection, I filled it white. So we have 100% black selection means fully focused. Dark gray selection very less blur. Medium gray selection means blur more than dark gray. And in last 100% white means fully blurred. To create a alpha channel, now you need to use gradient. Select the first layer and then add the gradient adjustment layer. Here are many gradient presets. You need to select black and white gradients. So in dark gray area, I used more black area that near the subject and gray that is a little far. Start with the black and fading it with gray. Now come to 50% gray that I want to more blur than foreground. After selection, added a gradient adjustment layer and change white color to the gray that was filled in the selection. Start with 50% gray and fading it with the light gray. In last come to white selection. This is the background area that I want to blur to show shallow depth. Start very light gray to 100% white. Now I converted all gray layers to smart objects by opening layer menu. Then selected all area with Ctrl plus A in Windows and Command plus A in the Mac. Then copy it and open the channel tab. Then create a new layer and this is an alpha channel. Use Ctrl plus V in Windows and Command plus V in Mac. Paste the selection on alpha channel. Then deselect the alpha channel and select the RGB channels and go back to layer tab. Now I am hiding the above layers where we created the depth map. Selecting the key layer, then choose filter, blur and lens blur. For preview, choose faster to generate quicker previews. Choose more accurate to view the final version of the image. More accurate previews take longer time to generate. For depth map, choose a source from the source pop-in menu. Drag the blur focal distance slider to set the depth at which pixels are in focus. If you set focal distance to 100 pixel at 1 and at 255 are completely blurred and pixel closer to the 100 are blurred less. If you click in the preview image, the blur focal distance slider changes to reflect the clicked locations and brings the depth of the clicked locations into focus. You can also specify the depth by using new crosshair cursor. Click that area where you want shallow or deep depth of field. Here you can see where I click with the crosshair depth in changing according to the depth map. Here I click on woman as a main subject that was black in the map and rest of blurred according to the map that I have created with the selective selections. Then click OK. You can also create a layer mask for a little adjustment. I change brush opacity to 50% and reveal the area that was blurred much that I don't want. In lens blur option, you can invert the selection or alpha channel you are using as a depth map source. Select invert. Choose an iris from the shape pop-up menu. If you wish, drag the blade curvature slider to smooth the edges of the iris. Or drag the rotation slider to rotate it. To add more blur, drag the radius slider. For specular highlights, drag the threshold slider to select a brightness cutoff. All pixels brighter than the cutoff value are treated as specular highlights. To increase the brightness of the highlights, drag the brightness slider. To add noise to an image, choose uniform or Gaussian. To add noise without affecting color, choose monochromatic. Drag the amount slider to increase or decrease noise. Blurring removes film grain and noise from the original image. To make the image look realistic and unretouched, you can return some of the removed noise to the image. Click OK to apply the changes to your image. I recommend again you watch the entire tutorial first and once you understand it, watch it again and try it for yourself. And also keep in mind, using Gaussian blur to create a depth of field is not the best way of doing this, and you clearly see that on the edges of the object. Using Gaussian blur to create depth of field is not the best way of doing this. As you asked, the lens blur is more realistic. Now recap, open an image, first create selector selection according to depth you want. Black is fully focused, gray is less blurred, and white is fully blurred. Use gradient to fade black to gray, gray to black, or gray to white. Select the R selection and copy them. Open channel tab, create a new alpha channel, paste the selection here. Unhide alpha channel, go to layers tab, select the main layer, use lens blur filter, select alpha from depth map source, use crosshair tool to select the main subject or the subject you want to blur or in focus. After adjustment, click OK, then you can watch the magic of depth map. So that's all for today. I will come again with the new feature of Photoshop 2020. Thanks for watching.